Hi, I'm Erica Vetrini, and I am delighted to welcome you to Access Health. Well, welcome back. We've talked a lot about how our mental and emotional states can directly cause health problems. Let's turn the tables a bit now and talk about how our body condition, specifically whether we're getting the right nutrition every day, can help resolve psychiatric problems. With us today is David Hardy, founder of Hardy Nutritionals, and we're rejoined, of course, by Janet Zapala, our nutritional expert.
Good to be here.
David, I'm so glad that you're here. You've developed a nutritional formulation that has been studied extensively in the treatment of mood disorders.
That's right.
So tell us, what is the scope of the problem?
It's a huge problem. Mm-hmm. Harvard University statistics say that in any given year, 1 in 4 in the population will have a diagnosable mental illness.
And you know, I think that women especially tend to suffer the most.
Absolutely.
Because they suffer in silence. Mm-hmm. They don't want to be a burden to their family and friends.
Speaking of family, you actually have some personal experience with mental illness in your own family. Can you tell us a little bit about that story?
I do. Several years after we started studying this, and I was working with hundreds of other people with mental illness, and so I began to understand more about the illness itself. Ironically, I came home one day and my son was completely psychotic. He'd had a psychotic break and was diagnosed with schizophrenia. And about a year after that experience, my daughter was diagnosed after the birth of a baby with postpartum psychosis, which is a little more rare than depression, but still there. And those experiences were devastating. Mm-hmm. I mean, my experience with other people with mental illness is one thing, but it doesn't hold a candle to when you experience with someone that you love.
Your kids.
So David, was there any sort of silver lining?
The biggest thing that came out of it was an incredible desire to legitimize this so that my grandchildren and your grandchildren and millions of others don't have to go through what my family went through. That kind of motivation probably would not have come had I not had that powerfully emotional experience with my own children.
It seems that people who suffer with mental health problems may be nutrient deficient when it comes to what they're eating daily.
There is mounting scientific evidence proving that minerals and vitamins indeed can have a powerful treatment effect on mental illness.
Very powerful. And as an example of that now, we're going to hear from Dr. Charles Popper, a clinical psychiatrist and long-term instructor at Harvard Medical School, who has used David's specialized formulas in his practice.
I first became involved in nutrition as a psychiatrist, observing a 10-year-old boy who had bipolar disorder, a very serious form of it. He was having major temper tantrums for an hour, 2 hours, 4 hours a day, every day for some months. He took a vitamin mineral supplement, and within 5 days, his symptoms cleared entirely. The tantrums were gone on the fifth day of treatment. And he wasn't even irritable. He wasn't even grouchy. Now, we don't have any psychiatric drugs that can do that. I've never seen a psychiatric drug do that in any case. So based on that one child, I began to pay attention to nutrition and to the use of vitamins and minerals in particular to treat mood disorders.
We don't always see that quick of a response with the supplement, but it was a great way to introduce Dr. Popper to nutrition because nutrition was not on his radar screen at all.
Now, it's just not any ordinary supplement that has this sort of effect. I know when I go into a drugstore or a nutritional center, I'm overwhelmed. I have no idea what combination, which form. I mean, it's just complicated.
When you choose a supplement that's not complete, when you choose one that's not properly balanced, when you choose one that's not very bioavailable, you don't get a very good response. We've found what the right amount is. We've also found a special way to put together our products so that the minerals become more effective, and it's very significant. The minerals we process in a way that combines the inorganic molecule with organic molecules so that it makes it into an organic molecule that is, in some cases, 100 times or more soluble than the,
that's the key,
inorganic form.
This is pretty important, and we're going to let Dr. Popper weigh in on this one.
Especially in psychiatry, when we're using these as medical treatments, we look for very much higher quality vitamins and minerals that are demonstrated to have much higher absorption rates than the routine commercial formulations.
The power of absorption. Right. What we eat, we have to absorb in order to get those necessary nutrients. I could not agree more with Dr. Popper on this one.
Our research speaks for itself.
Right. Mm-hmm.
There are over 23 medical journal publishings from 15 universities, 4 different countries. Our supplement is the most studied supplement for mood disorders on earth. We're excited about the research and the verification that it gives what we do.
It is so exciting, David. And Dr. Popper is another prominent example who believes very much in this research. Let's take a look.
If it turns out, with more effective studies, that we can treat depression, bipolar disorder, attention deficit disorder, perhaps other psychiatric disorders, with vitamins and minerals that were as effective as the current psychiatric drugs, but with much fewer side effects and better long-term stability, and with less mental fog, if that were to turn out to be true, then we would have a much better set of alternative treatments to be able to offer patients who are currently struggling with these conditions.
So Dr. Popper clearly agrees that the use of specific combinations of vitamins and minerals can have a big impact in the way that people practice psychiatry.
When you understand how minerals and vitamins work in the body, that they're the basis of every metabolic process, they become not only the most logical, but also the most likely cause of all kinds of illness. Mm-hmm. So research does show that they positively impact and reduce the level of cancer and heart disease and Alzheimer's and many other chronic illnesses that we suffer from.
Why can't I get that from food? Why do I need a supplement?
It's just not in the food anymore.
So the best approach to good health, of course, is always prevention, preventing illness. Using a complete nutritional supplement, I think, is a solid step in the right direction.
David, thank you so much for being here, a wealth of knowledge.
Thank you.
And Jenna, thank you as always.
Pleasure.
And wow, what a depth of experience Dr. Popper brought to this discussion. Mm-hmm.